Good morning, children. Last class we discussed about this data file. What the data content we stored in the memory is known as what? Data file. The data file can be of two types. We can refer the data file in the memory as in two forms. One is a text file, another one is a binary file. When we consider the binary file, the binary file will be of what? Only the machine language, that is binary numbers. The data what we stored will be stored directly as a binary codes and will be accessed in the binary numbers. Whereas the text file that consists of what? ASCII code or ASCII code or a unique code values. Instead of having a binary number 0s and 1s which have what? ASCII code. Now we can consider the file is a text file, that means with the ASCII code value. Okay. Now we can discuss about our example. It will be easy to understand. Consider we have one file in memory about our 12A class children. We are storing the memory content as first name Eric Galvin, comma A, he is belongs to the class A, 17 years old. Jeremiah Renan, A, 17 years old. Maulika, A class, 17 years old. Saumati, A, 17. We know then A, 17. Like we are storing the information in one text file. The name of the text file we can have it as what? 12A.txt. The file is stored in C colon temporary folder like we consider. Okay, so the file contains of 5 lines because after this one it comes to the next line. After this one, this comes to. So 5 lines of information, it's having some of the characters. That is in the form of name, sex and age. Okay, now we want to open, this file is stored in our C colon temporary folder, we stored this file. Now we want to open this file. How we can open? So to open the file, we must use a function openOf, file openOf. This file openOf function has to be used with one file object. This file object has to be assigned with the open function consist of a file name, comma file mode. The file mode default mode is read mode. We'll discuss about the next what is file mode. Now the file name. See here, we are giving the path where the file is located in C colon. That the folder, we have a temporary, this is the directory, the folder, we are storing the file named 12a.txt. So here C colon after the double slash and then after this folder that has also double slash. The double slash specifies the path directory here. If you are using the double slash, we can give the file function open with the file name, the file mode, etc. Suppose here we are not using this backslash b. We know about this backslash n means what? Escape character specifying new character. Backslash b means what? A blank space specifying. So the backslash having a meaning of one character will specify one action. It is about one non-printable character. We learnt about in the literals, the early class in 11th standard. Backslash refers character constant. Followed by the backslash, one character will refer what is the non-printable, the backslash tina tab, backslash n new line, like we studied about this backslash character. Now here we are using the backslash, then the backslash t will be refers what a tab space, it will not go for the directory. So that we are using a double slash. Suppose you want to use the directory path with a single slash, then what we have to do, we must use one letter r before, that is in front of the file name. Instead of using double slash, you want to use the slash only to refer the directory folders. Then what we have to use, when we want to use a single slash in our file, the letter R to be used in front of the file. That means file object equal to openOf, then R character followed by the file name in quotation. That is C colon, in that directory folder temporary, in that folder 12a.txt is a file name. So here, this R character that denotes slash should not be considered as a escape sequence. The slash is refers what? The file folder path only. Like that. I hope that you are able to understand what is file open function. Thank you.